Well, let's discuss this now with Rod McKenzie, Managing Director of Policy and Public Affairs at the Road Haulage Association. Rod, thank you for joining us once again on the Wake Up Call. I'm hoping you can set me straight this morning. I'm hearing different things from different people. I mean, you know, we just heard from Pete about how difficult it is. Other people are saying to me, Anna, no, it's fine. It's just more paperwork. People will get used to it. Where are we?
Well, Anna, I think it's really stressful and really difficult. If there are a few people who are saying they can cope and it's all fine for them, well, I'm delighted to hear it. But the vast majority of traders and hauliers that we speak to tell a very different story. They talk about a mountain of paperwork that's hard to understand and even harder to get right. They talk about a shortage of customs agents to professionally do this work. And of course, if you are able to employ a custom agent, you're more likely to get it right, but there aren't enough of them. And lastly, there's the sheer bureaucracy of crossing the border, exacerbated by having to get COVID tests. And that has meant long delays for drivers and for the things we need.
Yeah. Yeah, it's really deeply worrying. I think, you know, when we talk about that supply chain, we've never been more conscious of that because it's become, you know, very much in the spotlight. So the question is this a short-term thing? Is this the bump in the road that some people have told me it is? Or are we just going to see this now? Are we going to see shortages in the shops?
Well, I think a couple of questions there. How long will it last? Who can tell? But I do think that it is in human nature that things will get better as people learn more about the paperwork and some of the stupid bureaucracy can be overcome. But I think it's with us for the next few months. But I'm sure after that, it will probably get better. So, I think that's really the key thing that people should focus on. And then you raise the kind of worrying question about, are we going to run out of food in the shops? No, we won't run out of food in the shops. But what you might see is less choice. Okay. Some of the things you're used to seeing on the supermarket shelves might not be there. And they might not be there for a short period of time or a much longer period of time, because maybe there are special rules around those things or special problems around those things that mean they can't be delivered.
Indeed. And coming back to the system then, you know, we've talked about the paperwork and we've talked about people getting used to it. Of course, this is all brand new. I mean, could we get to a point where it's not really workable? We need to make some tweaks and changes. And if so, is that possible now or is it all set in stone?
Well, the problem, this is a political question. And clearly, all this stuff is linked to the free trade agreement with the EU. So you feel it's unlikely that the EU would be renegotiating that to be up for that. But, I think this is a question for the politicians. If we've got something which doesn't work, are we just going to let it go or are we going to do something about it? And obviously, I think if it becomes as difficult and as challenging over a period of time, as you've heard from White's Transport this morning, then I think political intervention is needed. We've already heard Boris Johnson talking about the Irish Sea problems, which are really immense, that he'd be ripping up paperwork that what wasn't helpful to our trade. I'm not sure how that can be done, but certainly some sort of intervention is needed.
And something else that's troubling my listeners at the moment are reports of some hauliers and some companies simply deciding not to come to Britain because they don't want to deal with all of this. How much truth is there in that?
Oh, there's a lot of truth in that. Most drivers who service Britain are Eastern European. And if you can ply your trade elsewhere in Europe where you don't get hassle and you don't have to have COVID tests every 72 hours, why wouldn't you do it? And we've heard anecdotally of many of them saying, look, UK's not worth the hassle.
Yeah. Okay. Will that go on? I mean, obviously, we hope, we live in faith that the COVID tests hopefully will not be needed in the future.
Well, exactly. There are various unconfirmed reports in the papers this morning about the French requiring PCR tests for all travellers to France. We've not got, my understanding, it is only an understanding, is that doesn't apply to lorry drivers. but we need that to be confirmed one way or another. But certainly if that was true, and I'm saying we don't know that it's true, that would create an extra level of bureaucracy and an extra 72 hours worth of delays while you wait for the results, potentially, on already a staggering customs and border operation.
And finally, Rod, I mean, is there enough information for, I suppose it's not the lorry drivers that need to do this, it's the companies, isn't it, that need to make sure that they give the right paperwork to the drivers. Do you feel Yes. that the communication is good enough?
The communication has never been good enough. We had TV ads before Christmas from the government saying you need to get ready, but they didn't say what to get ready for what, and they didn't explain the complicated process, nor indeed is the complicated process explained terribly well online on government websites and all the rest of it. And this is why traders have really struggled with the form filling. They want to pick up a phone to a customs agent to say, do this work for me. Mm-hmm. But number one, that then adds to their cost because they have to pay quite a lot of money for that. And number two, we discovered there aren't many customs agents anyway, and you can't get one for love nor money at the moment.
On that point, Rod, we will obviously keep across this here on BBC Radio Kent. If I may beg of you, look in your diary for perhaps a week or two's time and we'll catch up again and we'll see how things are, because, you know, we were given to believe a lot of hauliers were taking a couple of weeks off actually as well. Yes. At the beginning of January. So check back in very soon, Rod. Thank you. Thank you so much. That's Rod McKenzie then, Managing Director of Policy and Public Affairs at the Road Haulage Association.